Hi, Remedy Guy here. With all the things that are going on, I hope you guys are all healthy and safe. Nowadays, most people are using their computers and laptops at home all day, and we know that the more we use our computer, the more data and files will be consumed by the hard drive. For the not-so-techy viewers out there, this means that there are no one-time fix for this, especially if you're using it heavily. What we can only do is to routinely clean it up whenever we notice our storage is starting to get low. Now what I'm about to show you is a demonstration on how would I go about freeing up space that I've personally been using. So without further ado, and to celebrate my 12 subscribers, these are several ways to free up space on your Windows 10 without any bullshit. This is my current available space in my local C, and since I'm keeping track of this hard drive, I'm expecting by the end of the video we'll be able to free up at least 10 to 15 gigabytes of storage. So to start with, we're going to do the most basic steps that we tend to overlook. That is, we're going to delete files that are mostly forgotten and we no longer use. So we're going to head over to Recycle Bin, double click, and delete everything just like so. Close it. Second one is to go to Downloads folder, or your documents folder, but for me, I don't normally put my files here, so I'm going to proceed to Downloads folder. And since we deleted everything in Recycle Bin first, what I'm going to do is I'll press Ctrl A, that's selecting all, and Shift Delete so that it won't go through Recycle Bin anymore. Shift plus Delete. Close it. And the last one is uninstalling applications that you think you're not going to use in the future. So go to Start Menu, type in Control Panel, Enter, Uninstaller Program. This is where you can find your installed applications in your computer. And as for me, since I'm not using Zoom anymore, I don't know about you guys, but I'm going to delete this one. Select it, uninstall. And after that, I'm going to close this one. And again, I'm going to head over to Start Menu. And I'm going to type in percentage, app data, percentage. What we're doing here is we're going to delete traces of Zoom that it left behind. We're going to look for the Zoom folder. Again, Shift Delete. Then press Close. Just in case you haven't deleted this before, let's disable Hibernate. Head over to Start Menu, type in CMD, right-click, Run as Administrator, and type in Power CFG space dash H space off, and press Enter. Then close and go back to Windows Explorer, refresh, and check how much space we freed up. In my case, I was able to free up, I think, 7 gigs of space. I just wanted to show you, just in case you haven't disabled this yet. Next one is temporary files. To delete it, just go to Start Menu and type in percentage, T-E-M-P, percentage. And by the way, when we put percentage signs, it means we're going to access the folders that are hidden. Press Enter. Again, Control A and Shift Delete. Again, Shift Deleting so it won't go through Recycle Bin anymore. Continue. Refresh, then close. Disk Cleanup. To access that, go to your Windows Explorer. Right-click Local C, Properties, press Disk Cleanup, then Clean Up System Files. Usually, this can free up a ton of space, as you can see here, especially when you just upgraded your operating system or updated your Windows using the Windows Update option. As you can see here, we can gain up to 5 gigabytes of storage since there have been multiple Windows updates lately. This might take a while, so just be patient. Press OK delete files. And when it's done, just press OK, then close it. Next up is System Restore. Just go to your Windows Explorer, right-click this PC, Properties, click on System Protection, highlight Local C, and just in case if this is turned off on your PC, it means it's not setting up restore points and it's not accumulating space, so you can skip this portion of the video and proceed to the next one. For those who don't know, restore points are basically the state of the PC at some point in time in the past. What makes it useful is that let's say you encountered a problem in your PC and you're not able to fix it. You can use the restore points to go back to the state of the PC which was still running fine. So usually we want this to be turned on so we have this some sort of safety net. If it's turned on, usually we can squeeze out some space, especially if you haven't touched this for a long time. Press configure. Inside, my first step is to enable this if this is turned off, then shorten the maximum usage so there will be a limit on how many restore points the system will create in the future. We can see that the system is using 1.2 gigabytes of storage, so we need to delete it. Press delete, continue, and press close. After this, a good practice is just to manually create a fresh restore point so that we can go back to this state if ever something wrong happens in the future. To do that, just press create, then type any name you want, but for me, I'm going to type in fresh, create, and wait for a bit. Press close, OK, close this one. Next up is storage sense. Go to start menu, type in storage sense, press enter. This is a built-in tool inside Windows 10 that automatically deletes temporary files that we don't normally need. This also goes through the folders we've been to earlier, just like recycle bin, temporary files, but we're going to use it anyway just to make sure no junks will be left out. So we're going to turn this on and click on Configure Storage Sense. We're going to check this box and clean now. Just go back, and as you can see, there's like your local C, but it's more categorized, and you can also click temporary files, just in case we missed something out. Remove files. And close it. Next up is cleaning up caches of the applications we frequently use. In my case, I'm mostly using Steam, Discord, and Spotify nowadays. But of course, you can still do this to the ones I didn't mention here. And take note that the space you can be able to free up depends on how often you use your applications. And also, don't worry, this is not going to sign you out or affect your account in any way. So let's go to start menu and type in percentage local app data percentage, enter. We're going to look for packages folder, double click, and we're going to look for a Spotify folder. Head over to local cache, Spotify, browser, then cache. Control A, selecting everything, then shift delete. Go back, go inside data, control A, shift delete. Then go back to local. Up next, we're going to Steam folder, HTML cache, cache folder. Again, we're going to delete everything inside of it. And for the Discord, we're going to have to go to app data folder. To do that, just click here, app data, roaming, then look for Discord folder, cache, Control A, Shift Delete, Enter. Okay, so for your applications, just look for it in your local or in your roaming folder. Here, I'm going to give you an example. Let's say this Telegram app. All you have to remember is to look for the folder inside that has a cache on its name and delete everything inside it. For this one, I'm guessing this user data cache. I'm going to delete this one, shift delete. And also the media cache. And we're done. Nvidia update. So this only applies if you have Nvidia graphics card. You can skip this part if you don't have one. Again, go to start menu and type in program data percentage. And look for Nvidia Corporation. Then downloader. Okay. So every time you update your graphics card to the latest driver via GeForce Experience here, those updates will be stored here in this folder. All of this folder with random letters and numbers and the folder named latest are the drivers we've downloaded and installed in the past. As for me, I think I updated 3 times. That's why I have 3 folders here. All downloaded drivers are going to pile up here and it's not going to be automatically deleted unless you do it manually. What we have to do is to delete those folders who have random letters here, here, and the latest folder. Shift delete, enter. Press refresh, close. The last one, I usually don't recommend external tool or applications, but sometimes they're actually really good ones, and the best thing about it is that they're free. I'm talking about Ccleaner. So the main purpose to why I use this application is to thoroughly check if there are still junk that is left to be cleaned. You know, we can't really be sure unless we do everything we could. All we have to do is to go here to custom clean, analyze, and wait for a bit. After that, run cleaner. I mean, don't get me wrong, there are good ones out there, but this one works best for me. It has a free version, and it's light. It does its job, basically. It also has Register Cleaner, which is a good tool to have, especially when you frequently installs and uninstalls applications on your computer. Just go to Scan for Issues, and wait for a bit. Fix selected issues, fix all selected issues, and then you're done. So all in all, I think we freed up at least 19, 18 gigabytes of storage space. Not too bad. Cool. And that's the end of the video. If somehow you find this video helpful to you, share it to a friend in need. And if you enjoyed these kinds of videos, please consider subscribing. There will be more like this coming. This is the Remedy Guy. Stay safe, everyone.